Hello, I'm Andrew Hernandez, and today I'm going to do my Motown video on my essay. So I did choose a song. I did choose The Tracks of My Tears by Smokey Robinson and The Miracles. So I will get into just the explanation of my essay and the song. So starting off, first of all, I did introduce the kind of just what Motown really is to give readers an idea of kind of what genre we went into. So I kind of explain, I'll start off. So I do explain, as we've gone through just many years of music, decades, years, genres, anything from that kind of, that kind of topic. So Motown's kind of a genre from back in the very popular in the 60s. And it originated in Detroit. And did produce some great artists such as Smokey Robinson, Marvin Gaye, some great bands as well, such as The Temptations and The Miracles. And The Miracles and the Smokey Robinson, the two that I focus on today, because they did collab for this song. So starting off, the song was actually originally produced by the Miracles. Smokey Robinson did help write it, and he did contribute in many ways, but mainly he did contribute to being produced. So Smokey Robinson is the lead singer of the song, and the Miracles do follow along as they're singing. So as we move along, we do get into that. It was also written by Smokey Robinson, Pete Moore, Marv Taplin, and some members of the Miracles as well. And also it was produced and came out in 1965 when it came out. 1965, sorry. And also, too, I do give an intro of who Smokey Robinson is. He is pretty popular as well from the late 60s to all the way up to the 80s. He was producing songs, very popular as well. And I'll start off with the article I did use. It was pretty close. So Tracks of My Tears is by Smokey Robinson and The Miracles. Kind of gives a harsh reality that some people are kind of, significant others and lovers, they're sometimes only temporary, which is very unfortunate, but part of that is just kind of part of life. And as I do go on, I'll get into the first bite paragraph. So at the end of the song, we do kind of hear Smokey give his demeanor, basically. He kind of expresses a demeanor of what he wants to look like. So first of all, the lyrics I do have down right here. As people say in the life of the party, because I tell a joke or two, although I might be laughing loud and hearty, deep inside I'm blue. So basically this line states that Smokey, the subject or individual of the song, is kind of putting on like a little act, I would say, or a mask, or just anything they can think of that's used to just cover up how you're feeling. So it's just a forefront, basically. And as we kind of advance throughout the song, it kind of shows, so he says, deep inside I am blue. So basically, that kind of admits to the listeners of the song or whoever is listening, reading the lyrics as well, if that's your preference. It does kind of show that he is not being true to himself and true to others and even this former flame. Not that that's a business, but still, he's not being true to himself is a direct point. And him not being true to himself, it does bring some, damage to himself as well. So as I get deeper into the song, the her individual, or Smokey, he kind of tries to give that demeanor or that he's trying to express, I'm okay without them, kind of showing that he's trying to move on. But in reality, as it states, we do know that he's kind of hard for him too. So after the attempts of kind of faking the happiness and kind of the moving on, he gives you that scope, that look into his life. Like, it's not, everything's not okay, And one thing too that kind of does throw people off is the rhythm or the beat of the song. And it's more so a sort of a upbeat, kind of not too quick. It surpasses a sad song, but not so much like a happy song. It's kind of in that awkward position, I guess, to me at least, in the middle, where it's not happy, too happy, but it's not too sad either. So it's kind of just just chilling here in the middle, I guess you could say, or just kind of just being in the middle. And as we go throughout the song, the beat does stay the same as well. So that's one thing I know we're told, I understand we're told to kind of look for transitions, you know, whether it's a rhythm, beat, or a switch up in the lyrics. They do a good job at kind of tying that to the individual's real feelings. I'll get into that in a bit. Next, I'll get into Body Paragraph 2. That one does go into depth with another piece of the song, so more lyrics, basically. Yay. So he does kind of advance to a... This is more so, I'd say, another 2 or 3 minutes of the song. The song's roughly 4 minutes, under 5 minutes. And here's the lyrics. It's a bit... It's pretty quick, the way he sings it. So he goes, "My smile is my makeup. I wear since my breakup with you, baby. Take a good look at my face, and oh, you'll see my smile out of place. Yeah. Just look closer, and it's easy to trace the tracks of my tears." So that is basically kind of him being defeat, or kind of giving the hint, you know, look closer. Am I really true to myself? Or am I really true to this image that I'm giving off? And the answer obviously is no. So as we kind of just dive deeper into this, we do see that he is a... Apologies for that, my bad. The beat doesn't take a sad turn. So that kind of confuses us. So as Smokey is singing these sad lyrics now, he's trying to kind of transitions to the realistic situation, the reality, is that he's really not fine with this decision that was made, you know, as expected, obviously. So going back, so he's going on to continue to state that he is, you know, not over this person. But later on, again, this song is kind of back and forth. So we do kind of take a little turn as well. So he does bring up that he has another lover, another person in his life. So he does go on, talking about how, she is there. Basically, it sounds like saying she's there temporarily. And, it's kind of just to show that, again, he is okay, or that he's fine, you know, to kind of not express at all that he's not hurt, you know, in reality that he is. And as I get into more so, I did get kind of into, it's not really technical, but I did get into the vocabulary of the song as well. I guess you call it the vocabulary, using the lyrics. I do look at the that vocabulary, for example, the words he used to kind of express his demeanor. So the makeup is what he referred to it as. It's just makeup that he's wearing, or just a mask, or just an act he's putting on to kind of show, like, you know, oh, on the outside, he's okay. But on the inside, deep down, he's actually hurting over this lover, or this relationship ending. That's one piece of vocabulary he does use. Another one too that he does go into is masquerading. And he does masquerade. Basically, so for example, being with this other lover, he does refer to her as a substitute. So kind of just substitutes from, you know, as a teacher, you know, they're there just to cover for the day or the week, you know, whatever the occasion is. It sounds like he's saying she's there for that purpose, you know, because he still has those hopes that she's going to come back when, you know, we don't know. He doesn't know. His hope is still there, but we don't know how strong the hope is. So going back to the vocabulary that I was saying that he's using, so substitute, masquerade, and the makeup were the three words that I did point out that seem, you know, very... They just stood out to me. So I did go with those words. And then rolling back to... So the real story within the lyrics is kind of express the difficulties that he's having moving on. He's tried looking happy and telling jokes, being the life of the party, to finding a new lover, which that did not work out. They said and called her a substitute, which I'm sure she wouldn't want to hear either. Again, not trying to get too far into that. But he does seem to kind of struggle with the place that he's in because he's trying to find the right path for him, whether it's faking it or accepting the situation or waiting for this lover. We don't know exactly what he wants, but we do know what he's attempting to do, though. And later on, he does go on to express that his hope does seem to be fading. So for example, his hopes, his intentions were to think, all right, if I wait or I show her I'm not, that I'm over it, she'll come back. It's probably not the case with the way the lyrics, the direction the lyrics are going. That's really not the case from what I've seen. So we do kind of get that spill from it. And as we do go on with the song, he's implying that you know, that he wants another chance with his former lover. Most of all, it's kind of just from the way I worded it, I would say admitting defeat, or kind of just the grief or the guilt, whatever you want to call it, your preference. It's still going to be there with him. So he kind of can't really get over the fact that it's over. You know, and we see that throughout the lyrics. So the more we kind of get into the lyrics, or actually the lyrics now, what I want to show is kind of the correlation or the connection that's kind of with the song, the lyrics, the individual, the feelings that it's given. I do start off with the lyrics and the beat. The lyrics, I think it's safe to say, don't really match the beat, because usually a sad song, sad beat, happy song, you're in love with the, you know, happy beat, you know, in love beat. It kind of just swapped a little bit. You got the sad lyrics with the more upbeat song. Again, like I said, it surpasses the sad beat, but it doesn't make it not enough for the happy beat. So what I'm trying to get at is that he is happy. He's not happy. The beat is happy, but the lyrics are not. Just like him, the demeanor he's given off, the feelings he's expressing, or just the actions that he's taking, he looks like he's okay, but in reality, on the inside, deep down, he's blue or he's hurting. And that does correlate or connect to the song, because that's the purpose of the song, to kind of show that it's that he's not over this lover. So going back to the kind of just the attempts to get over her, he doesn't tend to find that, you know, getting over stage. We don't know if he's there yet or not. And going back, now going down to the conclusion of the song, I did say, looking back at the lyrics, on the correlation of the heartbreak to faking that, you know, he's okay, or the happiness, it's kind of just like a, not a trauma response, but more like a, just like, you know, being protective of yourself, you know, because, you know, you're very vulnerable in that time, you know, in that stage, you know, heartbreak, you know, it's early, whoever you are, I'm pretty sure it's normal to feel vulnerable. He doesn't want to feel like that, because again, he wants to give that demeanor that he's happy, that he's okay, you know, doesn't need this individual in his life, which is, I would say, a pretty normal response, because you don't want to give out that demeanor. I used to say, I do admit the song does kind of fool us as well. We kind of sit there, you know, I called it like a ping pong match or a tennis match, because it's just back and forth. You don't really know where he stands some of the time. And then you kind of later on learn, you know, okay, he's sad, but he's faking his happiness. So those go hand in hand. But what I'm trying to get at from here is the lyrics, tears are usually associated with sadness. You know, sometimes there's happy tears, but in reality, I know myself personally, I do correlate or do associate tears with sadness usually. And getting to that, the tracks of my tears, that's not like a sad title. I would say it's a sad title. But you hear the beat, it's a little more a beat, you know, kind of quicker, and you don't really expect like much sadness from it. The lyrics do start off with a happy, you know, people say on the life of the party, kind of just what people think of him. And that's what you can tell it's what he cares about, because he's giving that fake demeanor off of, you know, that fake, you know, I'm happy, but I'm okay on the inside, and he's not. Then you roll a few seconds later into the lyrics, and it does show he is sad about this breakup or this relationship ending, that the absence of this lover, or this flame, as they call it, is not there. He cannot accept that. And then we hear basically his tactics, or kind of the actions that he's taken throughout this breakup. So he does find another lover, but this lover is not her. And he tends to masquerade, but in reality is not okay. So again, like I said, it's kind of like the tennis effect, the ping pong effect. You do not know where to settle down. You're kind of like, all right, is he over? Is he still grieving over this? It does confuse you, but as you get into the song, you do get the final answer. He's not over this breakup or this relationship. And it's pretty obvious. The more times I listen to it for this song, millions of times, it also was my project too. It's also a great classic as well. It's just settled at that point that it's more so about, oh, I'm heartbroken over this individual. And that's mainly what the song stands for, those are the intentions. And lastly, what I do have is a bit of the song that I do want to play. And the portion that I'm playing is the kind of lyrics just personally that stood out to me from the vocabulary and the masquerading and all of that. Here it is. So that is the last roughly 45 seconds of the song, and that does give us kind of just the direct point of the song. So kind of just, hey, I'm faking this, but I'm not okay. I'm not over this breakup. Very straight to the point, and it helps out a lot. So that's all I have for my Motown video, and thank you.